It's our favorite religious whipping boy, Andy Bannister, back with another load of religious nonsense. This time he wants to convince us that atheism is a belief, using some of the worst logic imaginable. But what else is new? This is Andy we're talking about, one of the many religious jokes wandering the wastes of YouTube. So let's see what he's on about as he tries to tell us that atheism is a belief, and why, as always, Andy Bannister is just wrong.
Is atheism a belief?
No, it's not. And this is interesting because I was recently involved in a discussion where a couple of people, including one atheist, if you can believe it, were declaring that atheism is a belief, mostly because they were arguing that everything, absolutely everything, is a belief. And that's something I've heard many times, and I strongly disagree with it. But I'm sure we'll get back to that as we see where Andy is going to go with this.
I'm often told by my atheist friends, no, atheism is just a lack of a belief. Or as the late atheist writer Christopher Hitchens once famously said, he said, our belief is not a belief.
Indeed, I think those people are right. I don't actually believe in atheism. I don't believe that no gods exist. I don't believe anything. I just don't take the unsupported and unjustified claims made by the religious seriously, any more than I take the claims made by UFO nuts seriously. That doesn't mean I believe that there are no aliens anywhere. I just don't think that claims made by the proponents are credible.
Well, with all due respect to my atheist friends who want to assert they don't believe anything and therefore don't have to defend it, I think that idea is wholly mistaken.
And likely, at least in my experience, you think it's mistaken because you want everyone to have a belief so you don't have to feel like you're all alone. If you can pretend that everyone is in the same boat, you can shift the burden of proof away from the claims that you actually make to the claims that you want to pretend other people are making as well. And that's why theists so often claim that atheists are arguing that gods don't exist, because they want some of the heat taken off of them. Sorry, it doesn't work that way.
Let's explore why by unpacking the idea that atheism is just the absence, just the lack of a belief in God. Well, if atheism is just a lack of belief in God, that leads to all kinds of strange conclusions. I mean, I can think of many things that lack a belief in God. Rocks, rubber chickens, Richard Dawkins' left foot, Australia, the colour blue, all of those things lack a belief in God. Does that make them atheists?
In fact, in a very real sense, it does. Of course, Andy is just engaged in the argument from absurdity, because the things he mentioned aren't capable of believing in gods or anything else. But from a strict definitional sense, anything that does not believe in gods is, in fact, an atheist.
I think it'd be a very strange person who would want to say that Richard Dawkins' left foot is an atheist. So clearly, to be an atheist means more than just a lack of belief in God.
Nope, that's it. And of course Richard Dawkins' left foot is an atheist. Do you think that some parts of his body believe in God and others don't? Are you nuts?
But the problems get even more profound. You see, the absence of anything can't cause something. If I take a hammer and I drop it on my foot, it will cause pain. But if I take a non-existent hammer and drop a non-existent hammer on my foot, it won't cause anything, because it doesn't exist.
Just like your God.
But atheism seems to cause all kinds of things. It causes skeptical people to write angry tweets at me on social media. Atheism caused Richard Dawkins to write a book on atheism that made millions of pounds and his bank manager very happy. And so the list goes on. So for a non-belief, atheism looks quite busy.
You're an idiot, Andy. Because while atheism in and of itself doesn't cause anything, the people who hold to atheism, the people who do not believe in gods, they do exist and thus can cause all kinds of things. Most of these atheists are responding to the abject stupidity pushed by the religious. Atheism doesn't exist in a vacuum. It is a response to the irrational claims made by God-botherers like you. If the religious just vanished, if the whole concept of religion ceased to exist, so too would atheism and atheists, because there would be no need for it.
Furthermore, people don't normally gather in communities or groups or self-identify around a non-belief. For example, I lack a belief in the tooth fairy, but I have never introduced myself at a party by saying, "Hi, I'm Andy Bannister, I'm an a-tooth-fairian."
That's because there aren't large groups of tooth-fairians in society trying to push their ridiculous beliefs on you. That happens with the religious all the time. And as I said before, any organization of atheists you see is caused by the existence and continued stupidity of the religious. Stop being idiots, stop trying to convert people to your cause, and atheists will largely leave you alone. And this gets really ridiculous the more you think about it. Anti-slavery advocates don't believe in slavery. The reason there was a whole war fought about it was because there were so many people who wanted to keep slaves. Once you got rid of slavery, abolitionism kind of vanished, didn't it?
But I've met many people who say to me, "Hi, my name is whatever, I'm an atheist." I know many people on social media who write atheist or skeptic or free thinker in their social media profiles. The more enthusiastic put the flying spaghetti monster or some sort of secular icon there, but they self-identify around the label of atheism, which tells me it means far more than just the absence of a belief in God.
It means they're actively opposed to the religious and the irrational ideas of religion. In a society where religiosity is the norm, where people are expected to be religious, where people are simply assumed to believe in imaginary father figures in the sky, sometimes people who oppose those ideas have to take extreme steps to identify specifically outside of that expectation. Again, get rid of religion, and all that goes away.
Atheists are increasingly forming themselves into groups and communities. They're starting groups on university campuses, they're meeting together in societies, they're having conferences, they are even starting churches.
Well, I do disagree with that last one, but for the rest, it's all a response to the stupidity rampant in society caused by the religious. Atheists are becoming organized to oppose the overt influence pushed by the religious on the society as a whole. It's a good thing. When the abolitionists were getting organized, they did all those things as well. And the church thing? Well, a lot of that comes from the rampant indoctrination caused by religion and people trying to get over it once they reject your primitive beliefs. Unfortunately, by using a lot of the same methods and rituals of the religious. And as I said, I disagree with it. I would never engage in it. But I have no control over what others do.
This raises an interesting question, doesn't it? Has atheism not just become a belief system, but is it actually a religion for some people?
It doesn't fit any of the definitions of religion, sorry. The dictionary definition of religion is the belief in and worship of a superhuman controlling power, especially a personal god or gods. So, no, atheism cannot, by that definition, be a religion. Do some people engage in some of the religious trappings? Yes, unfortunately, often as a coping mechanism for the mental poison pushed on them by the religious, which again is just dealing with the problem of religion, which is all organized atheism actually is.
Now maybe you're watching this and thinking, atheism, a religion? Are you insane?
We all know you are. Even you know you are, which is why you disable comments and voting on your videos. You're terrified that people will be able to disagree.
Well, it depends how you define a religion.
I already did. Atheism doesn't fit. Next.
A religion doesn't necessarily mean a belief in God. Most Buddhists don't believe in God.
And Buddhism, at least some forms of it, isn't a religion, it's a philosophy. Certainly there are plenty of religious Buddhists out there who do believe in gods, but once you excise the belief in the supernatural, you've pretty much wandered outside the bounds of religion.
The academic description that's used by many anthropologists for what a religion is a system of thought that attempts to answer ultimate questions.
Which atheism doesn't do. And of course, I did a Google search on that phrase and came up empty, so I kind of doubt that anyone actually defines religion that way. In fact, most of the references I got were to Douglas Adams' Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. So no, Andy, I don't believe you.
Where did the universe come from? Is there a purpose to life? Why are we here? What's gone wrong with the world? How are human beings supposed to live? And I suggest my atheist friends have answers, or believe they do, to those questions.
Again, none of which are even addressed by atheism. But then again, I bet Andy has no idea what atheism actually is, and all of his so-called atheist friends, I don't think they actually exist. But I bet he's got a hot girlfriend in Canada, doesn't he?
And then lastly, I think one of the signs that something is a real, active belief is other things accumulate alongside it. So, for example, I'm a Christian, and because I'm a Christian, I believe certain things about justice, I believe certain things about truth, certain things about philosophy that follow from my Christian faith.
I don't think they do, certainly not if you read the Bible. And this is the same kind of nonsense you get from Christians claiming that Western civilization came from Christianity. Correlation is not causation, I'm afraid. You're far more likely to have come to those concepts because you live in a Western democracy, not because you're a Christian.
And likewise, many of my atheist friends believe certain things about science. They believe that we're just atoms and particles, that there's no purpose built into the universe, that we're just the result of time plus chance plus natural selection. Most of my atheist friends are materialists, to give that worldview its proper name.
But none of those things are beliefs, and this is something that I have to keep explaining to the religious. Not that they can get it through their religiously addled minds. Those things are facts. Once you have facts, things that can be demonstrated with objectively verifiable evidence, then you don't need belief. Belief and faith become meaningless. And of course, that's where materialism and naturalism come from. Evidence. They're the only ideas for which we actually have any. Therefore, they're the only ideas that we ought to take seriously. It's why the supernatural is so utterly stupid.
And the very fact that atheism attracts these other beliefs tells me, again, it is a belief. It really is a positive belief, not just the absence thereof.
And there goes Andy again, looking at things completely ass backwards. The only common thread behind any of this is skepticism, the idea that nothing ought to be accepted unless it can be objectively verified and evidentially supported. So you get to atheism from skepticism, not skepticism from atheism. You get to rational atheism from demanding that any claims be backed up with proof and rejecting any claims that cannot be. As is no surprise, Andy is wrong again.
Now, I say this not to belittle you, if you're an atheist watching this, but to challenge you to realize you do have beliefs. There's no such thing as a human being without faith. All of us believe something.
Except for all the people who are, of course. But as I said before, he and most of his religious brethren want to insist that all people are just like they are, so nobody can criticize them for being irrational. So they insist that the opposition is no different, even if that's not true, just to shut people up. And apparently, they think we can't see right through it.
If you're messing around with the claim that atheism really isn't a belief system, I suggest it's really because you haven't dared to put it to the test and see if it stands up. Why don't you stop being infantile, step into the adult world, and examine properly what you believe, what others believe, and see whether what you believe stands up.
Says the guy with an imaginary friend. And that's really where all this falls apart when you get right down to it. Theists like Andy here spend a lot of time telling atheists what they believe. They spend a lot of time insisting that they know more about what goes on in our heads than we do, which is absurd to the nth degree. And when you disagree with them, they tell you that you're wrong. Not sure how that works. They insist that you have faith in the non-existence of gods, whether you do or not. They're sure that you have beliefs when you're very certain that you don't, and when we say so, they call us liars. It's really ridiculous when you think about it, because they live in a fantasy world of unsupported assertions and blind fanatical faith. Nothing they claim can be demonstrated to be so with objective evidence. On some level, I think they know it. They know they're nuts, so they want to drag everyone else down to their level of insanity. It just doesn't work that way. We're not crazy. We're pointing out their lunacy, and they've got no means of showing that we're wrong. So they just want to strap a straitjacket on everyone. Sorry, I pass.
Everything changes.